Good evening. Welcome to the fourth iteration of our annual honor band. We have to take a couple years off for the great what have you 2020-2021, but we're really, really pleased to be back and be back in our revamped auditorium, which is looking sparkling and clean and nice this evening. I'm Dr. David Wall. I'm the director of bands here at Concord. I've been here at the university for about 13 years now, and I'm the person who created this wonderful event, or headache, if you prefer, for you this weekend, however it may land on you. I brought a student out on stage this evening. We'd like to ask you to sign up your cell phones. We've done a lot of work this weekend polishing music. All the students here have done a fabulous job. And I thought if your phone were to ring during the concert, we would ask you to come up on stage and do a little performance on the screen for us. Just an incentive. This is the largest group we've had for this event. We had over 240 people registered, 240 students, and we've had 19 institutions, which is by far the largest group. Last year when we had this event, we had 80 students. So it's been a massive turnout and an amazing job. I'm not a parent myself, but I know that sometimes kids aren't forthcoming with information, so I'll give you some prompts on what they've done this weekend. They've been here all day yesterday and most of the day today. They've had four rehearsals in this building, in this room, in the band and choir room. They've had lunch in the cafeteria twice. They've had a tour of the campus. And they had master classes with a few artists from other institutions as well as here and some band directors. And they saw a little concert last night that we did at the end of the day, a little jazz concert. So, if they're not forthcoming with information, there's some prompts for you to get some information from them. Once again, please silence your phones. The event is live streamed tonight. You should be able to find it. It's Concord Live. It should be on our main website at universityofconcord.edu, as well as, I believe, on Facebook and through our YouTube channel. So that's really exciting. We're very privileged to have two, I called them, when I introduced them before, I said Jedi Masters of the band tradition and legends here at Mercer County. The first band has worked with Mr. David Kade all weekend. We're so thrilled to have him back here work with him. Give you give a round of applause for Mr. David Kade.
Thank you. Thank you. about the band world and band music, he is a critical writer. Passed away in September. I think it was 20 years younger than me. And he, it was really strange circumstances. He went into cardiac surgery and complications and gone. So we're going to dedicate this to Rob, but he's still my soul. Thank you.
Thank you.
download.
That's great. A lot of work goes into performing a 20-minute program in 2 days, so an amazing job. As an MC, I suppose I should probably come up here and try to come up with some whizzy banter. That's what everybody said in the stage for the day. There's a lot of thank yous I should probably get to. A few of them are in the program. And that reminds me, I should say, a lot of things go into events like this. There are a lot of moving parts. And we try our best to make sure that everyone has a great time and has a very educational weekend. Things slip through the cracks, and we make mistakes in the programs, so we try to do right by that, adding an addendum in there to make sure everyone's done on the floor. And even when you add an addendum sometimes, you still make mistakes. So we do apologize if there are any mistakes in the program. Also, I think we only printed about 300 tonight, so if you did get a program and you would like one, please let your local band director know, and I will print some more. It's no problem. Keep safe for everyone. Speaking of band directors, there's some backstage, but are there any band directors participating this weekend in the house? Would you stand up and let us applaud you? Thank you for your efforts. A couple of you are in the air. Several of them are backstage on wings hanging out right now. Without them, this would absolutely not be possible. In addition, I would like to thank the Concord band students. We have about 10 students helping out this weekend, and they're really the people that are running the show here. Everyone's moving chairs, moving stands, making sure everyone gets to where they need to be all the time so that they don't go lost. Will you please thank the band students for helping out? Similar, but 70 chairs and 70 stands is a lot. Also, percussion has to be changed at each time as well, because not every band is playing with the same instruments, of course. Speaking of that, no school in the state that I'm aware of owns 12 timpani. Timpani are very large, very expensive instruments, so we do have to loan equipment each time that we do this event. And it's a pain to move. So I would like to thank both Shady Spring and Highview High Schools for loaning their equipment to us and for their directors and their drivers for bringing that equipment here and back. So thank you so much, everyone, for loaning your equipment. All right, I'm going to let them finish setting up and then I'll come back out. To the building. Mr. William Bailey is here tonight live streaming the event for us, which is an outstanding thing, so that if you can't be here from a long distance, you get to watch online. So give it up for Mr. William Bailey. I believe it's in the program, but I meant to say when Mr. Kade was out here representing Mercer County for, what is it, 35 years in the program? That's an outstanding career. Very fortunate to have him in the community. Our next group is conducted by Mrs. Kade, and she just told me that she spent 38 years teaching, with 30 of those years at Princeton Senior High School. Really fortunate to have her at the event. Are we all set on stage? Yeah, okay. So please welcome Mrs. Kade and the great band.
Thunder. It's the NASCAR theme. How many do that? Did you know that? It's an NASCAR thing. Yeah, I didn't know either. It's very simple. The next thing we're going to do is the Jupiter hymn. I'd like to tell you a little bit about it. The Jupiter hymn comes from the fourth movement, Jupiter, the bringer of jollity, from the orchestral suite of the planets by English composer Gustav Holst in 1874 and up to 1930. This was written between 1914 and 1917. This is the Jupiter hymn, one of my favorite hymns from that fourth movement. Hope you enjoy the Jupiter hymn. Voyage to the sixth planet. The work is comprised of four sections. on a launch pad, and I think that would be, you'll hear that at the very beginning, a little bird says to us, lift off, and then, oh my goodness, we get into trouble in Taco Bell, and then the orbital sunrise. It's very powerful and very lyrical, grace to the patients, and our percussion section is going to be the nuclear fuel to get us into space. Just wanted to add that. They did a great job. Also, we have flute soloist Marie Medina, flute trio Marie Medina, Berkeley Davis in the Boswell, and four solo Sarah Park. Ladies and gentlemen, Saturn.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. This is the wind ensemble group. The difference between a wind ensemble and a band, we usually have one person per part, maybe two for sound reinforcement in this band. When you have less people playing a part, it makes everyone an individual, a soloist, if you will, as we say in band. That first piece was by Dr. James Suchinski. He was one of my teachers from undergrad, a good friend of mine. He passed away last January. So I'm trying to do all of his compositions over the next couple of years. It's based on a famous German student song, as Jim would say. And it was originally written for by Johannes Brahms in his academic festival orchestra, overture for orchestra. And this is a reimagination of that piece for sessionals and fanfares and commencement and things like that. So that's for Jim Suchinski. The next composition is by Barnes. It's a variations on a Korean folk song. So it's going to start, I'll give you a little roadmap of the composition so you have something to listen to. It's going to start with the clarinets stating the melody in a nice, beautiful, low, rich, luscious, velvety range. And then each group of instruments is going to state the melody at some point. So it's beautiful and lyrical at the beginning. Then we're going to have a very fast section. We're going to test their fingers, see how fast they can move those fingers, right? We may have gone over it once or twice. Then we're going to have a lyrical section, and then we're going to have three more variations, one of which is going to feature the percussion section. So try to hear the melody as it goes, weaves in and out of the variations. So very challenging work to do in 2 days. I couldn't be more proud of what they've done with it. So this is variations on a Korean folk song.
Thank you.
night, but putting it together in 2 days is quite a task. Very proud of how much work they put into that. A lot of notes to play in there. The next composition is by a Russian composer named Chechnikov, primarily known for his vocal compositions or choir compositions, about 500 pieces total that he wrote, 400 of which I think are vocal works. He's also known for writing a manual for choral conductors to assist them in rehearsing choirs cleanly, clearly, really well. This is based on a Ukrainian chant melody as well as if it was sung from the Psalms. So with all the war going on in the world, this is kind of the perfect combination of material for a program. Chechnikov worked in the Christian Orthodox Church, and I think it was Stalin at the time had that church destroyed during his lifetime. And it's said that after that church was destroyed, Chechnikov didn't write any more compositions the rest of his life. So he never actually got to hear this work. It's originally for 6 to 8 voices. Before he was writing, a lot of the music that was out there was really melody and accompaniment. So when he came along, he wanted to have independent lines, so each voice would have a really unique melody, for everyone to sing. So the voices weave in and out of each other. So that's one of the things we worked on the last couple days is chamber music. When you have a particular note or section, you need to bring that out. You are the most important voice. This is Salvation is created by Chechnikov.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you again for coming out this evening. May all your favorite bands stay together and a safe drive home.